everyone. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create conditional logic based on your appointment type information in Gravity Forms. Now, for the specific tutorial, we're going to be using the Gravity Wiz Populate Anything perk. This allows us to dynamically populate our live forms as the user fills them out and populate the field choices and values. And just to give you a quick preview on the Populate Anything perk, I have this dummy form set up just to show you. So here you can see we have a few things going on. For example, we have this, what we call a live merge tag. It's going to be practically just a merge tag, only we're going to add the ampersand at the very front. We also have this field down here where we have the populate value dynamically checkbox selected. And this is also included in the Populate Anything perk. And it pretty much lets us fill in both values and choices dynamically using things like the post, taxonomy term user, Gravity Forms entry, or even from the database directly. And just to give you a quick preview, you can see that both my labels, my choices, and my values were all automatically populated just based on my entry on this first field. Going back to our initial form here, I have this demo form for a sorcerer. He's pretty much just booking magical services. And the only thing is that depending on which service or which appointment type they select, he wants to collect additional information. So if somebody books an appointment with the spell consultation calendar, he has it set up so that you can specify what spell you'd like to discuss during the consultation. This is set up using conditional logic, but it's only possible using the Populate Anything perk. So let's go ahead and get started. All right, and so this is not going to be a complete overview on Gravity Forms or Simply Schedule Appointments. Just to give you some context, let me show you what I have set up in Simply Schedule Appointments. So heading to the Appointments dashboard, and here under the Appointment Types tab, you can see I have a few different calendars set up. But the ones we're going to be using for the specific video are the ones marked with the sorcerer label. I've already gone ahead and set all these up to my liking. All we have to do now is simply just add them to our Gravity form. Here in my Gravity form settings, I already have this local town sorcerer booking already set up. This is something we already saw on our front page. But just to give you a quick peek at how this is set up and what we'll eventually do later in this video, you can see I have my name and email fields here. I have my SSA appointment field set up. I have a hidden field, which we'll come back to here in a moment. And we have our radio button filled with different spells. Let's go ahead and get started. I'm going to create a blank form. Next, we'll add the required name and email fields. And we're also going to go ahead and add the SSA appointment field. And let's go ahead and rename it. Right now the label is marked as untitled. And we want to select only the appointment types that I had designated for this form. And that should be about it for this field. Let's go ahead and continue adding more. Next, we'll add in our radio button. So now we have our basic fields added. I'm going to go ahead and save this before I forget. And so now what we want to do is we want to only show this radio button field if the spell consultation appointment type is selected. So to do this, we're going to be using the Populate Anything live merge tags feature. Coming back to our hidden field, we actually need that hidden field to store our value or to store the appointment type title value. So let's go ahead and add that in. And the reason we need to store this value is so that we can reference it in the conditional logic settings of our radio button. So here in my hidden value settings, I'm opening the advanced tab, and here in the default value field, I'm going to enter my live merge tag. So Simply Schedule Appointments actually offers quite a few different merge tags, and you're welcome to visit our guide to go over all the different types of merge tags. And these pretty much just pull information from your booking. This is a great way to customize notifications, confirmation screens, but in this case we want to use it to auto-populate our live form and use conditional logic with them. And so in this case we're going to be using this appointment type title merge tag. So I'm going to go ahead and copy it. I'm going to go back to my form, and here in the default value, let's go ahead and enter this merge tag. And the next thing we want to do is go ahead and replace the field underscore name filler and the field underscore ID filler. And what we're going to use to fill these in is this book your magical service appointment type. So one thing we are going to need to copy is the label. So I'm going to copy book your magical service. And then the other thing I want to do is take note of this ID that comes up here at the very top of the settings for this appointment field. So here you'll see that the ID is 4 for this particular field. Now going back to the hidden field, let's open up the advanced tab again and edit our default value. So the field name, you're going to replace that with the label that we just copied, in this case, book your magical service. And then the field ID, we're going to replace that with the number we just took mental note of. So that's a 4. And the last thing we want to do is add in the ampersat to pretty much just tell our form this is a live merge tag and we're using populate anything to auto-populate this. Next thing we want to do to finally complete our conditional logic is head over to the radio button settings, and here at the very bottom you'll see that it says conditional logic inactive. We'll go ahead and select that and enable the conditional logic. Now we have the option to show this field if all the following criteria match. In this case, I just want to use my hidden field. So here it's already pre-selected for me, hidden field. And then I can use this middle dropdown. In this case, I just want to say is, for example, the hidden field is equal to blank. And so here in this last text field, it says to enter a value. So in this case, I only want to show this field if the appointment type title is equal to spell consultations. Now that we have that set up, let's go ahead and save this again. And that pretty much wraps it up. So here I have my name and email fields that are required for SSA to work properly. I have my SSA appointment field set up correctly. I have my hidden field that holds my merge tag, my live merge tag. And I have my radio button field that holds the list of spells. And again, we conditionally want to show this just based on the appointment type or the calendar that the user books with. All right, so let's go ahead and preview this and see how it works. All right, so let's fill it in. And as you can see, this field was not visible before, but since I've booked a time in the spell consultation appointment type, now I have the option to provide this additional information, and I can select submit. All right, let's take a look at our entry. So as you can see here, my hidden field collected the spell consultation appointment type title, and I have my spell. Now if we head over to the appointments dashboard, you'll see that my booking came through here at the very bottom, and if we view the appointment details, I have this information here as well, so I can pull this into the SSA notifications if I need to as well. I hope this was helpful. Please let us know if you guys have any other questions. We really love the Populate Anything perk, and we think it does such a great job at creating magical gravity forms, and SSA works very nicely with it. Please let us know if you guys have any questions, or feel free to share any forms that you create with this awesome trio. And again, thanks for watching.